Hi, my name is Ronnie Dutta, and today we're going to talk about the Chera Dynasty of Southern India on Let's Talk About Bharat. The Chera Dynasty was one of the principal lineages in the early history of the present-day states of Kerala and Tamil Nadu in Southern India. Recent studies on ancient South Indian history suggest that the three major rulers, the Pandya, the Chera and the Chola, based originally in the interior Tamil Nadu at Madurai, Karur Vanchi and Urayur respectively, had established outlets on the Indian Ocean, namely Korkai, Mucheri and Kaveri Pumpattinam respectively. Territory of the Chera chiefdom of the early historical period consisted of the present-day central Kerala and western Tamil Nadu. The Cheras are referred to as Kedalaputo or Kerala Putra in the Emperor Ashoka's Pali edicts. The earliest Greco-Roman accounts referring to the Cheras are by Pliny the Elder in the Periplus of the 1st century CE and by Claudius Ptolemy in the 2nd century. After the end of the early historical period in South India, there seems to be a period where the Chera family's political prestige and influence declined considerably. It is possible that with the decline of the Roman trade in the 5th century, there was a corresponding fall in the stature of the Cheras. But by the 7th and the 8th centuries, large portions of southern India was under the control of the Pallava and Pandya rulers. It is likely that the surviving Chera royals were the vassals of the Pallavas and the Pandyas. Several inscriptions of the Cheras ruling from Karur, mostly placed between 9th and 10th centuries, are found in central Tamil Nadu. This line of kings was increasingly coming under Pandya influence, and a new Chera kingdom was taking shape in modern Kerala. By the 8th century, the old Chera territory was split into two separate kingdoms, one based at Karur in central Tamil Nadu and the other based at Kodungallur in Kerala. Royal inscriptions and temple grants, the major source of information about the rulers of this period, refer to both clans as the Cheras. Identification of the Cheras in each record is a matter of major scholarly discourse, and the exact nature of the relation between the Cheras of Karur and the Cheras of Kodungallur remains obscure. While the Pallava and Pandya rulers in Tamil Nadu emerged into established kingship by 5th to 6th centuries, the formation of the monarchical polity in Kerala took place after the 9th century. A line of Chera rulers described in royal charters and temple inscriptions as the Perumals are known to have ruled what is now Kerala between the 9th and 12th century. Historians tend to identify Nayanar Saint Cherman Perumal and Alvar Saint Kulasekhara with some of the earliest Chera Perumals. An identity different from the Tamil-speaking people to the east of the Western Ghats gradually emerged in Kerala in the medieval period. Oldest forms of Malayalam language and earliest signs of increased Nambutri Brahmin influence are also attested in this period. Several notable literary works were composed during this period under the patronage of the Chera rulers. Kodungallur, the major spice trade port in Kerala at the time, was also a center of learning and science. An observatory functioned at the capital under the charge of Shankara Narayan, an astronomer in the court of Chera King Sthanu Ravi. Narayana is the author of Laghu Bhaskarya Vyakha, a commentary on the works of Bhaskara I, a disciple of the famous polymath Aryabhatta himself. When the Kodungallur Chera kingdom was eventually dissolved in 12th century, most of its autonomous chiefdoms, including Venadu, became independent. The rulers of Venadu, based out of the port of Kollam in southern Kerala, claimed their ancestry from the Kodungallur Cheras. They had an oscillating relationship with their powerful eastern neighbors, the Pandyas of Madurai. With Kolathunadu in northern Kerala, it remained the most significant kingdom in Kerala till the emergence of the Zamorins of Kozhikode. In the Venad royal family, like in most of the royal houses in Kerala, the law of succession followed was based on matrilineal inheritance. The eldest son of the sister of the ruling king, not his own son, had the legal right to ascend the throne after the death of the king. In the modern period, the old state of Venad was divided into several autonomous collateral branches such as Travancore, Kottadakara, Kollam and Nerumangara. The rulers of Venad owed their importance to exchange of spices and other products with the Middle Eastern and Chinese merchants. Venetian adventurer Marco Polo claimed to have visited Venad capital Kollam, a major center of commerce and trade with East and West Asia. European colonizers arrived at Kollam in the late 15th century, primarily in pursuit of the Indian spices and textiles. The geographical advantages, like the favorable monsoon winds which carried ships directly from the Arabia to South India, as well as the abundance of exotic spices in the interior Ghat Mountains, combined to make the Cheras a major power in ancient southern India. The Chera Dynasty produced what was termed the finest steel in the world, that is, ceric iron, to the Romans, Egyptians, Chinese and Arabs. The steel was exported as cakes of steely iron that came to be known as woods. The famous Damascus blades relied on the unique properties of the woods, crucible steel from medieval South India and Sri Lanka. I hope you liked this video about the Chera Dynasty, and if you did, please share it with your friends, your family. Subscribe to MyNation and keep watching. Let's talk about Bharat.